Hi everyone, Michael here, and Steve Hackett has been kind enough to drop into Lick Library and spread some wisdom amongst us. I've been asked to ask him some questions. Hi Steve, nice to meet you.
Hi Mike, nice to meet you too.
Let's do the formal introduction.
Yes,
hello,
yes.
Nice to see you. First question I should ask you is, having watched footage of you over the years, you seem, to me, I mean I could be speaking completely out of turn, but you seem like a classical guitar player that's turned to electric guitar playing. What did you start on acoustic first of all when you were a young Turk?
Yeah, no, I never learnt to play classical guitar properly. I've done albums of that sort of stuff, but in 1965...
You've done a ton of that sort of stuff.
I have, yeah. But at the same time as 1965 was the year of the Beatles, it was also the year of Bach and Segovia for me.
Yeah.
So I grew up listening to both those things, you know, blues and Bach and Beatles. And so they were all one to me, really. I just thought, this all sounds fantastic.
So how old are you when you started playing?
Okay, I started playing harmonica first of all when I was about two. I was born in 1950. So I was trying to get a sound out of instrument then. By the time I was four, I was playing the odd sort of, the odd tune. But really,
at
it wasn't
four?
Until I was 12.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? Yeah, I know, it sounds...
You got musical parents or?
Yeah, my dad was musical. My dad could get a tune out of most things. Not professionally, but... and then he became an artist around about the time I became a professional musician, around about 1970-71. But it wasn't until I was 12 that I was able to get my hands around this very large guitar that he had that he brought back from Canada, and that was an acoustic F cello hole thing. And even at the age of 12, you know, it was a bit big for me, a brutal action, like barbed wire and... He said, well, yeah, they're all like that. You just got to fight through it. And so, you know, 6 months of bleeding fingers. And I think, when are the calluses going to come? They never were ever going to come. They're just lacerations. I just say, yeah, grit my teeth. I really want to do this. And so there's an aspect of that that lives with you, isn't there, as a guitarist. You go through the pain and don't realize that actually, you know, there's a friend of mine who had a nylon guitar that he bought for all of £6 at the Army and Navy stores in Victoria. And I picked that up and I thought, this doesn't feel like a real guitar. This feels like the difference between silk and barbed wire. You know, it was just so gentle, the action. So I fell in love with that straight away, then convinced him to put steel strings on it, which was a great idea for about 6 months. And then one day I was playing it, because I'd virtually taken it off him. By then, and the bridge just went, and I said, sorry mate, perhaps they were a bit, you know, the tension was a bit too much for it. So, yes, early career as a guitar wrecker.
Yeah.